Welcome student. Now in this video we are going to discuss the next idea called prepositional equivalence. Called prepositional equivalence. Or this can also be we can say logical equivalence or logical equivalence. What is the meaning of this? I am having two logical statements. If the logical statements have the same output, with the same output, then they are called logical equivalence or propositional equivalence. Logical equivalence or propositional equivalence. If the final output of two or more statements are same, then they are called logical equivalence. See, for example, show that. If we take an example. Negation P double implies Q and negation P double implies Q or logically equivalent or logically equivalent. What is the meaning of this? I am going to find the truth value for the first statement or first logic or proposition, and I am going to find the truth value for the second proposition, and I am going to check are they same or they equal. Now in the first one I am having P, I am having P and Q. So we are having two statements, P and Q. My P will be true, true, false, false. Q will be true, false, true, false. Correct. Now I am going to check the thing. What is the requirement? I am going to find P double implies Q. And then I am going to find the negation opposite of the result. So for double implies, we said when we have the same statement, the result is true. I am going to check here. I am having the same statement. The result is true. Here I am going to check. I am having the different statement. The result is false. I am having the different statement. The result is false. I am having the same statement, the result is true. Now I am going to find the negation. The meaning of negation is opposite. True will become false, false will become true. False will become true, true will become false. So the output or the result of negation P double implies Q is nothing but false, true, true, false. This is the first one. I am going to take the second one. My second one is nothing but negation P implies Q. It implies Q. So I am going to take what is P. I am going to check Q, and then I am going to find negation P. Finally, I am going to check negation P double implies. So P value will be always true, true, false, false. Q value is true, false, true, false. Now I am going to find the negation of this opposite. True will become false, true will become false, false will become true, false will become true. Now I am going to combine this two using double implies. Bidirectional. For bidirectional, when I have the same statement, the result is true. For biconditional. When we have the same statement, the result is true. I am going to check here. I am having different statement. That means the result is false. Here I am having the same statement. The result is true. Here I am having the same statement. The result is true. Here I am having the different statement. The result is false. If we check now, the final output of this and the other one are same. False, true, true, false. False, true, true, false. If we get the same output, then they are called logically equivalent. So we are going to write like this: negation P double implies Q, and negation P double implies Q are logically equivalent. Logically equivalent. If you find a different statement or different answer, then we are going to say they are not logically equivalent. This idea, here we have given an example for two statements. This same idea can be followed for other multi-propositional statements. When we are having three or more, we can use the same principle and we can say if the final outputs are same, then they are called logically equivalent. They are called logically equivalent. Understand the idea now? So now we are going to discuss the next idea called bitwise operation. Bitwise operation, you know that very well. In computer, always the system follows the bits. What is the meaning of this? When the truth value is true, I am going to assume the bit as 1. When the truth value is false, we are going to assume the bit value as 0. 1, 0, 1, 0. Here, we can find all the principle, all the operation we can perform on this bitwise string, and then we can find the. For example, find the values of bitwise OR, bitwise AND, bitwise exclusive OR for the bit string. They have given two bit string. One is 011, 011, 011, 0. And there is another bit string 110001, 1101. We are going to use the same principle, you know that very well. For OR, if I have two false statements, the result is false. That means here I am going to take, when I have two zero, the result is zero. For AND, when we are having two true statements, 1 and 1 is equal to. For exclusive OR, when we are having the same statement, the result is false. And the result is false. We are going to use the same principle and we are going to find the bitwise operation. For your comfortability, I am writing in the column. I am taking the first one as Q, P, and the second one as Q. What is the first one? This is 0. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. The same way I am going to take the next string is 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. Correct? You can use either horizontal or vertical, you can find the answer. All the ideas are same. First, I am going to find the bitwise operator on P or Q. P or Q. What is the meaning of OR? We said when we have two statements of false, the result is false. I am going to check now. Here, 0, 1. One statement is 1, so the output is 1. Both the statements are 1, the output is 1. 1, 0, one statement I am having 1, the output is 1. 0, 0, both the statements are 0, so the result is 0. Correct? So we say when we have two same when the two statements are formed, the result is formed. When we have two zero, the final result will be zero. 1 0 again, I have 1, so the output is 1. 1 1, the output is 1. 0 1 1. 1 1 1. 1 0 1. 0 1. That means in only in one place we are having 2 0, so the result has become 0. Otherwise, the result is 1. The same principle. The same principle. The next one I am going to find bitwise AND. This is all. I am going to find bitwise AND. So for AND, when we have two statements of 1, the result is 1. We said we are having two statements are same or 1, the result is 1. I am going to check this 2 for AND. So what is the value now? Here one statement is 0, the result is 0. Here both the statements are 1, the result is 1. Here one statement is 0, the result will become 0. Here both the statements are 0, the result will become 0. Here one statement is 0, the output is 0. Both the statements of 1, the output is 1. I have 1 0, the result is 0. I have both the statements of 1, the result is 1. 1 0 0 0 1 0. So when we have two statements of true, the result is true. The same principle. The last one we are going to check for exclusive OR. For exclusive OR, if I have the same statement, the result is false. If I have the same value, the result is false. I am going to check, I have the different values, so the result is 1. I have the same value, the result is 0. I have the different values, the result is 1. I have the same value, the result is 0. I have the different 1, same 0, different 1, same 0, different 1, different 1. So the basic principle for bitwise operator is same as the logical operator what we did before. We are going to use the same principle, just we are going to convert the truth value, true to 1, false to 0, true to 1 and false to 0, and we are going to perform the same idea, we are going to perform the same operation, perform the same operation. Thank you. Here we are finishing chapter 1 and we will continue chapter 2 in the next video.